Hello friends, today I am going to tell you about the what are the rubrics and I will give you some examples of the rubrics as well. So today I am going to tell you about what are rubrics. So you can see the picture over here and you are looking at it. There is a table in front of you and on vertically you can see that there are some criteria written over here, and in columns you can see levels of performance. So criteria should be decided by the teacher and level of performance should also be decided by the teacher or the department. It depends, or if it is in a school, so it must be decided by the school as well. But criteria can be selected or decided by the teacher. And what are the criteria, what are the level of performance? Yeah, I will tell you here today. Hopefully you will understand it about the rubrics. What are rubrics? So first of all, I am moving towards the definition of the rubric. A rubric is typically an evaluation tool or set of guidelines used to promote the consistent application of learning expectations, learning objectives, or learning standards in the classroom, or to measure their attainment against a consistent set of criteria. So, for example, in the past, what are the practices of the teachers? What they do? They normally give you assignments, presentations, or it may be quiz, projects, whatever they want, or assignments, whatever they assign you. They do not describe you what are the criteria of criteria to check your consistency, to check, to measure your abilities, to measure your learning, to measure your learning experiences. So they do not define it, and normally you are for example, it was also happened with me that we were not aware of that, what teacher really want us. So nowadays, what we are working for it, we are working for the rubrics. We will define it before giving you any assignment, quiz, or you can say project, whatever, presentation, for example. So we all define you what are the performance criteria on which we will assist, or we will check your performance, or will measure your ability. So we define it before, so you students now understand it, what are the qualities or learning experiences. We will check it and we will mark on that. So on this basis, students are decided what they have to do. They must know it in the start, initially, what teacher is asking for them. So it is the best practice. We have to define a rubric before giving any assignment, project, lab project, and whatever we want to give to the student. We have to define them what are the abilities and learning capabilities will be checked or assessed from that assignment, quiz, or you can say presentation or any project. So now I'm going to the very, very, very initial example of rubrics. And this is the rubric of a kindergarten student. Itself made it, and you can see in the rows that there were performance criteria written over there, and you can see in the column that there are some level or level of checkings. So for example, criteria are what? This is as kindergarten student writing rubric. So it is according to the writing rubric. My ideas make sense, my writing is organized, my writing shows emotions and feelings, I use strong words in my writing flows. It means there must be coherence in the writing. I use punctuation, capitalization, spaces correctly. I spelled word wall correctly and all that. So for example, if a student did mistakes in the spelling, so what will happen? For example, he or she did lots of mistakes. So he must be at the beginning level 1. So I will mark him 1. And for example, the second criteria is developing. For example, somewhere he or she spelled correctly, she wrote spellings correctly, so I can give marks 3. And the highest level is the strongest level. It means there is no spelling mistakes. So I am talking about the last one, performance criteria. So you can give 5 marks out of 5, for example. So this is the way to check the performance criteria. So my ideas make sense, whether there is a sense of story, or there is a sense of the topic related to the sentences related to the topic, or the sentences related to the topic or not. So we will check on these basis. It's up to the teacher, whatever the criteria they design it, and it's up to the teacher, but you have to word accordingly what are the criteria is going to be checked. So your level performance level will be assessed accordingly, na? So you have to work accordingly. So your assignment quiz will be up to the mark and according to that level which your teacher is asking for. So if I'm moving towards our level, so what we have to do there, you can see skill sets or criteria sets. For example, this is the rubric of lab. Laboratory, and it was the engineering mechanics laboratory rubrics. So you can say sensory skill to identify equipment or its components or a lab work. So if you are looking here, so what you will see, let me cite the height floating meeting controls. You can see psychomotor domain assessment rubric level P3, extent of achievement. What are the extent of achievement is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for example, a student was unable to identify the equipment, so he marks 0. So I will categorize him at the first level, and it is very initial level, not able to identify the equipment. Or the highest level is able to identify equipment as well as its components. So I will mark him 4 marks. And it's up to the teacher how much work he or she assigned it. Or we can also say that outstanding and best work or developing need improvement, like this, we can say that. So procedural skill, display skills to act upon sequence of steps in lab, if he is following the procedure, whether or whether not, and it in which category he lies is, for example, not able to either learn or perform lab work procedure, whether he is able to perform or not. If he is not, so he will score 0. Able to slightly understand lab work procedure and perform lab work, okay, if I assign him, so he or she will get 1 mark in that portion, in that performance criteria. Second one, able to somewhat understand lab work procedure and perform lab work. And these performance criteria can vary from lab to lab, from project to project, from presentation to presentation. It's up to the teacher what the performance criteria they want to check or assess. They will define it, and you have to work it accordingly. Hopefully you will understand it. For example, response, ability to imitate the lab work on his own, whether he is able to do lab work, follow the procedures, whatever the methodology teacher is defined him or her, whether he is working accordingly or not. So teacher will mark it on the, for example, if someone has a response, ability to imitate the lab work on his own, has the highest ability, so I will mark him on the 4th. So if I will tell you according to the Excel sheet, so you can see the 3rd performance criteria and the 4th one, highest degree. So we will move into the third row and 4th column. So for example, observation, how display skills to perform related mathematical, whether he is able to calculate mathematical calculations, whether he is able to handle equipment properly. So this is the level for each and everything here, for every performance criteria. So the level is from 0 to 4. It's up to the teacher how much mark he or she wants to assign it to the assignment, project, or whatever the work or task or say case study is given to the students. So he or she will assign it accordingly. So hopefully you will understand it, how rubrics work, and what is the concept behind the rubrics, why do we make rubrics, and what is the definition of the rubrics. So thank you so much. Bye bye.